Guys, we have seen a pullback in the Bitcoin price right now. Is this something we need to worry about? And could this be the start of a bigger correction? Or could we see a bounce from here and continue this uptrend? Guys, I'm going to show you exactly in today's video what Bitcoin needs to do and which levels are very important to determine whether Bitcoin is going to see a bounce and can continue this uptrend, or whether Bitcoin might see a bigger correction. Then guys, Bitcoin has been respecting the levels I've pointed out in yesterday's video perfectly. So guys, we are going to have a look at that, and I as well going to give you an update about Ethereum and the Bitcoin comparative, because we are continuing seeing bullish signs. So guys, awesome to have you here. Drop a like, leave your comment down below. With that being said, my name is Sharon. Welcome to the Blockchain Today, the channel where you subscribe for daily crypto videos. And right now, let's jump into the content. This video is brought to you by the Prime XPT platform. Prime XPT is an exchange where you can trade over 50 different assets using Bitcoin as collateral. You can trade Bitcoin and a variety of other cryptocurrencies along with Forex, commodities and indices like the S&P 500 or the Dow Jones. Recently, Prime XPT launched GoFesting, where you can follow other traders and profit from their trades. And you can as well create your own trading strategy which others can copy. And if you right now sign up using my affiliate link down below, you can get a special deposit bonus of 35% and a 25% discount on your fees. Take in mind, guys, that leverage trading does carry a high risk and that you should know what you're doing before trading with leverage. This is for experienced traders only. Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Awesome to have you here. And let's start off directly with having a look at Bitcoin on the daily time frame. And first of all, we are going to have a look at the dump that we have seen in Bitcoin, the pullback which we are seeing right now. We had a drop of approximately 16%, and as I said in my previous videos as well, we most likely going to see Bitcoin's price going towards the 20-day moving average, because in a uptrend, this moving average is working like a magnet. When Bitcoin is overextended, it is getting pulled back to the 20-day moving average. And if we right now have a look at the 20-day moving average, then we can see that Bitcoin right now is holding support on this level, which is right now at approximately $17,000. And guys, when we have a look at previous strong uptrends, then we can see similar things. Bitcoin is increasing rapidly, but eventually always get pulled back towards the 20-day moving average. And if the bull trend continues, we are seeing a bounce from this approximate level. Then guys, in yesterday's video, I've mentioned the important level of 17,600, and I've said that if we were to break the level of 17,600, we can expect a further drop, because that is an important support level. I'm going to show you exactly why. And I have also mentioned the next target, which was at 16,400, and we've reached that next target as well. And guys, let me explain why the 17,600 was such an important level. Well, right here we can see that we were in a uprising channel, or in a rising wedge pattern. Eventually we broke the resistance of that rising wedge. That is something, yeah, Bitcoin already doing for quite some time right here in this strong uptrend. But we have created a clear resistance right here, a uptrending resistance, which turned after we broke back above it into support. And that was the level of 17,600. And if we have a look at a horizontal support level, then we can see that the 17,600 held support in the past as well, the moment we broke above it right here. So that was the reason why I was looking at the 17,600 level. And that's as well the reason that the moment we broke below this level, we saw a continuational drop in the price of Bitcoin. Then the next level that I was watching was the level of 16,400. And guys, the reason I'm watching this level is if we go one rising channel below this rising channel right here, we've also created a resistance, which afterwards, when we broke above it right here, it turned into support. So this was another trend line that I was watching, and I'm expecting a reaction in the price of Bitcoin. And as you can see, on this trend line, we got a bounce. So these are actually quite respected trend lines. And guys, this is also showing us that right now, even though we are seeing some bearish signals, Bitcoin has seen quite of a drop right now. I'm going to talk about that more in a bit. But we are actually still in the uptrend. On the daily time frame, we are still above the 20-day moving average. So yeah, if we are seeing a bounce from these levels, then Bitcoin still could continue this uptrend. This is not yet a confirmation that we are right now in a bigger correction, which could go to the 20-week moving average, for example. So guys, the previous time Bitcoin touched the all-time high, that was in December 2016, right here. You can see the moment we've been touching the all-time high, the previous all-time high, which we have created right here in 2013, we saw a sell-off. We got actually a pullback of 30%, quite a aggressive one, which lasted for 2 weeks. So it was really shortly lived. And afterwards, we started a new uptrend. And in the second try right here, we surpassed the previous all-time high. We saw another sell-off, most likely because investors, they are having feelings of uncertainty, right? Due to the fact we are entering territory, price territory, we back then have never entered before. But eventually, you can see that Bitcoin catched up with this uptrend, and eventually the price just went parabolic. And guys, this is something we need to take in mind as well, that if we are breaking the previous all-time high, let's say at approximately $20,000 decisively, that is the exact moment when Bitcoin and cryptocurrencies will get a lot of media attention and a lot of people will be aware of the bullishness of Bitcoin. We, on the other hand, have been already in Bitcoin since the whole bear market of 2018, which is our advantage. We already have a lot of knowledge. We know how these markets working. We know what we can expect with Bitcoin. We are not getting easily shaken out when we are seeing such drops. So that is definitely our advantage in the bull market that is coming right now, which the new investors don't have. Like, guys, listen to the story. Like, a couple of days ago, I got a call from my old friend asking me if it's smart to go all in on Ripple right now, because Ripple has seen such a pump. Well, my first reaction was, of course, well, hell no, you should definitely not be doing that. So guys, you and me, we know how these markets work. We know that we have to buy when nobody's talking about a certain asset, when nobody's talking about Bitcoin, or when everybody is negative or completely panic selling. That's the exact moment you want to buy. And when friends are starting to call you, asking you like, hey, should I go all in on XRP, for example, then yeah, that for me is definitely a huge sell signal right here in the short term. It is showing me right now that the euphoria stage, the mania we have seen in 2016, 2017, that yeah, something similar is boiling up right now in the background. But yeah, guys, nevertheless, last time we've touched the previous all-time high, we got a drop of over 30%. So yeah, right now we are not seeing that yet. We have a drop of approximately 16%. So yeah, this is actually quite still a small drop when we have a look at a normal pullback when testing previous all-time highs, right? So this is nothing yet to worry about, in my opinion. If we were to break the 20-week moving average, which means that the market structure is actually changing, then that is definitely a worrying signal. But yeah, right now we are so far from the 20-week moving average, which right now is right here in the orange line, is at approximately 12,500. Then guys, I quickly wanted to share this chart with you, and this is the golden ratio multiplier. This chart is visible in lookintobitcoin.com, but you can also use it right here on TradingView. You can add the indicator, the golden ratio multiplier, and right here on the daily time frame, we can see that these levels are actually quite respected. So right here, the green line is the 350-day moving average times 2, and right here, the red line is the 350-day moving average time 1.6. And as you can see right here, is that this is the approximate level that we were getting rejected and that we were starting to see this pullback. But if we have a look at the history, then we can see that these levels are actually getting quite respected. Like right here in the run-up in 2019, we got rejected by the 350-day moving average times 1.6. Afterwards, the times 2 350-day moving average was acting as resistance, and the price was bouncing in between. And right now we got rejected from the similar level right here. We didn't overshoot it like we did in 2019. But yeah, we do see some significance from this level. So guys, this indicator I personally think is actually quite interesting and might sign us in a more of a structural way, in a more midterm perspective, if we would see a bigger correction, like for example, if we would break the 350-day moving average times 1.6, the red line right here, if we would break it decisively and we would backtest it as resistance, then that could give us a signal that we might be seeing a midterm downtrend. But right now we are still bouncing between these two levels. I thought they were interesting pointing out because it looks like the price is respecting those levels. So then guys, let's dive into the 4-hour time frame, and I want to point out that the moment we dropped here, we had this 16% drop in the price of Bitcoin, we did saw a significant amount of volume. So normally when we are seeing the Bitcoin price increase or decrease with such significant amounts of volume, then that could indicate that we are going to see a continuation of that move. So guys, do take in mind that this pullback might not be over yet. We could see another drop, and the levels that I'm watching right now, the support level that I'm watching right now, is the level right here, the level of 16,400. If we were to break below this level, then I as well expect a further drop in the Bitcoin price. Then guys, I want to use the Fibonacci retracement tool as well right here, from the bottom right here till the top. Then we can see that the support right now, slightly above the support, is the first Fibonacci level of 23.60%, which is approximately aligning at 16,500. So slightly above the support that I'm watching at 16,400. But this could be an extra confirmation if we were to break below this level, that Bitcoin could see a continuational drop to the downside. Might even could go to the next Fibonacci level right here at approximately 15,000. So guys, take that in mind. If we have a look at the 1-hour time frame, then we are seeing something interesting occurring as well. I want to apply the Fibonacci retracement tool from this top, the bounce right here, till the bottom right here. Then we can see that we have been retracing to the golden ratio so far, and that the price got rejected at the golden ratio, which could mean that the bounce we are seeing right now could be a retracement from the drop we have seen right there. So normally when we are seeing a drop, we could see a bounce before we are seeing a continuation. And that bounce, most of the time, if it is a retracement, so we are seeing a continuation, gets rejected at the golden ratio, where we are seeing a rejection right now. And we could also draw a neckline right there. So we draw a horizontal resistance line right there at the golden ratio, slightly above it. And if we would go to the 30 minutes time frame, then we can actually see that we're potentially forming a inverse head and shoulders. Guys, normally I don't like these patterns, like a reversal pattern of a inverse head and shoulders. I don't like it on the shorter term time frame right here in the 30 minutes time frame. However, we are testing this neckline, the golden ratio, already multiple times, so I thought it's interesting to point out. So what I'm watching right now is what the price of Bitcoin is going to do. Are we going to get rejected from the golden ratio right here? Are we going to see a continuational move to the downside? Then this bounce definitely looks like a retracement. And then the next level that I'm watching to break is the 16,500, 16,400. If Bitcoin can break above this neckline and we can find support on this neckline, then I'm watching the next level, which we broke through, of course, the 17,600 level, which right now the resistance is slightly above because this trend line is increasing as well. So right now I would say that the resistance would be at 17,700. If we were to get a rejection from that level, I think Bitcoin could still see lower levels and we could see a further retracement, a further pullback. But if Bitcoin can break back above 17,700, then it definitely starts to look more bullish for Bitcoin. But guys, then the last level I want to point out is the Fibonacci retracement from the top right here till the bottom, because we still always could get rejected right here at the golden ratio, which right now is starting at approximately 18,170 all the way up towards 18,270. Because if we would get rejected from that level, then yeah, that could also mean that from this drop we have seen right here, from the swing high right here to the bottom we are seeing now of the pullback, that we are seeing a retracement back to the golden ratio before we see a continuation will move to the downside. So guys, take that in mind, that this is a potential scenario as well. However guys, Bitcoin I do think is still looking quite good, and if we have a look at previous time we start testing previous all-time highs, it is very logical that we are seeing a sell-off. You know, a lot of investors, they feel uncertainty. They know Bitcoin is overextended, and yeah, for sure a lot of people are taking profits in these regions. So guys, it's nothing to worry about yet that we are seeing a sell-off here. This is definitely very understandable that yeah, a lot of people are taking profit around these levels. And guys, we can see right here that the neckline is as well a important Fibonacci level, the 38.20% from the total drop. So that is also something to take in mind. If we were to break above this level, then we can see an increase. But however, do take in mind that we still have the golden ratio above us, which could still mean that this could be a corrective structure to the upside before we are seeing a continuation to the downside. Then guys, a bullish sign I want to point out in the Bitcoin chart is that we are seeing a hidden bullish divergence on the 4-hour time frame. We are seeing the price creating a higher low. Actually, right here, you can see the price creating a higher low. But if we have a look at the RSI, then we have been creating a lower low. So guys, this is showing us that most likely there is still bullish momentum in the price of Bitcoin. And yeah, this is going against the fact that we are going to see a bigger correction right now. And this is in favor of the scenario that we are seeing a smaller pullback and are continuing this uptrend. We can see it on the daily time frame as well. Daily time frame, we've created a higher low, but the RSI created a lower low. This is not yet confirmed. However, guys, it is always bullish when the RSI is retracing further than the price. That means that the RSI is creating space for more bullish momentum. Then guys, yesterday I've been talking about Ethereum in the Bitcoin comparative, right? We have seen a drop, which we actually expected because we were seeing a bearish divergence, a lower high in the price, but a higher high in the RSI, as you can see right here. So this is showing us that we might see some increased bearish momentum, and we also had signs in the Bitcoin dominance, right, that we most likely are going to see a bounce. So guys, this was actually quite all nicely predicted, and right now I want to point out the level where we are seeing a bounce from is quite significant. If I use the Fibonacci retracement tool from the bottom of the move till the top, then we can see that right now we are seeing a bounce from the Fibonacci golden ratio. Guys, this could be an early sign that this move, this drop to the downside, is a small retracement from the pump we have seen in Ethereum mini Bitcoin comparative. And if you have a good look at the wick right here, then you can see that yeah, a lot of people were still buying Ethereum in the Bitcoin comparative. So liquidity from Bitcoin went into Ethereum. So that's actually quite bullish. And I think this is an early sign that Ethereum can continue this uptrend. However, guys, if we were to break below the Fibonacci golden ratio, then that would invalidate this bullish signal. But okay, guys, that was it all for today's video. I hope you all enjoyed it. If you all enjoyed it, please consider leaving a thumbs up. You are really making my day, and you are really helping out pushing this video to as much people as possible. Then next to that, guys, I want to thank you all for the engagement I got on yesterday's video. You guys really made me so happy with getting more than 200 likes on yesterday's video. Then guys, I wish you all an amazing day, and for everybody who hasn't seen one of my tutorials, you can go over there and watch one of those, and I will see you all in the next video.